In the year 1859, John Brown, acting as Isaac Smith, led 18 volunteers on a raid at Harper's Ferry, Virginia. Brown, a radical abolitionist, believed his action would enable him to capture the weapons at the Federal Armory, and the weapons would then be used to fuel a rebellion that would free all slaves. During that raid, a contingent of U.S. Marines, commanded by Colonel Robert E. Lee, surrounded and captured or killed Brown's raiders. Brown himself was captured and then hanged on December 2, 1859. The execution of Brown was public and was witnessed by the actor John Wilkes Booth, who 6 years later, in April of 1865, would assassinate President Abraham Lincoln. Colonel Robert E. Lee would resign his commission in the Federal Army to become the commanding general of the Army of Virginia in the Confederate States of America. In other events in 1859, composer Victor Herbert was born, Oregon became the 33rd state, Charles Dickens published A Tale of Two Cities, Charles Darwin published Origin of Species, and the iconic clock tower called Big Ben began ringing its bells over London. In that same year of 1859, William Henry McCarty was born in Manhattan, New York. Patrick Floyd Garrett was 9 years old and living on a plantation in Claiborne Parish, Louisiana. John Henry Tunstall, the son of an English nobleman, was 3 years of age and living in the borough of Hackney in London, England. And Lew Wallace was 32, serving as a legislative representative in Indiana, and would, in 2 short years, serve as a general in the American Civil War. Circumstance, serendipity, and some would say fate, would draw the lives of these four men together. One would become the matchstick that lit the fire of an extraordinary and bloody feud. One would end a life and help create a legend. One would publish a first novel that would become an American classic. And one would become the most famous outlaw in American history. But in 1859, Henry, John, Pat, and Lou would not have known that in a few short years, they were all destined to collide violently in a wild and lawless place called the New Mexico Territory.